morning, everyone. Let's start with our daily market commentary. So what we see in front of us is S&P 500. So if I just look on the weekly format, S&P 500 is basically on the verge of a complete upside, right? So what I see over here, this was the point where a slight pullback came on the downside, then it reversed and gap up, and almost the week ended with a positive note. So 2 weeks of positive green candles, almost trying to breach the higher level, which was the prior resistance. So two times it has been the resistance, third time it has come over here, trying to sustain the base of 2790 and can zoom up almost towards its high. So this week can be a decider week, because if this turns positive, the candle which is right now almost little red, if it turns green, then it can basically spark a new upside rally for all the markets. So specifically for Nifty as well. If I just see on the daily side, as you are trying to see, the importance of multiple resistance, right? It has basically now gone almost above that and trying to sustain on the daily basis. So what we see, this is where the downfall came. Again, it went up. The rise was very fast, right, on the upside. So small pullback, again, gap up opening, trying to go on the higher side. So it is good that it is resting for last couple of days around that same zone of breakout, which basically gives him a more potential upside before it starts the rally. So this is very important for us. When we basically see the S&P 500, we get some kind of confidence building into the system. Second most important thing after this S&P 500, let's open the dollar index. Now what we saw on the dollar index was pretty much clear. After the small decline over here, there was a sharp rise. That is why the dollar also went up almost towards 69 or so. But what I see now after the commentary of Fed, every week it is trying to make new high. So dollar index is trying to make new high. It has not been able to make, right? So that is one of the good thing that we should basically understand, because now the dollar will not depreciate more. USDINR will not depreciate more. So dollar strength will basically go sideways, if not upwards. So what I see on the dollar side, it will not go towards 78, 72 or so on the Indian brochures. So the point is pretty much clear. On the higher side, on the weekly format, it has been undergoing a large amount of stress. What I see on this today's week also has started, this week has also started with red. So one good news is dollar will remain range bound now till the Fed basically realizes to increase the interest rates. So till now they are not for this particular meeting as well. So I would basically anticipate dollar moving down in this zone towards 93.75 or so. Now, understanding this, that dollar will not be on the higher side, two main effects will come into play. Number one, if you basically now look at USDINR, so dollar will not become strong. So that clearly indicates that USDINR will not go up. Now it will come down. So what I see on USDINR on the weekly format, this was the last time high, came back down. Again, it went up on the higher side. Now what I see on USDINR, it has been again making continuous same highs on the weekly format, has then gone sideways. Now something which is very important on week, if you see two candles, almost same lows have been made. And today what we see, the start of this week has also made the low on the same direction. So 3 days, the same low is there. Right, so 3 weeks, the same low is there. That shows a clear downside potential available for USDINR almost towards 67.87. So a kind of, if you consider from 68.4 to 68.8, this is the kind of downside which is quite possible. Right, so approximately 60 paisa on USDINR, 60-70 paisa downside is quite possible, right, in this expiry itself. So this is what is seen on the weekly side. Now let's go and see on the daily side. Are we seeing the same thing or not? As I basically said, this is the important landmark, because multiple lows have been made on the weekly candles, right? So this clearly shows something very exciting. And this was the prior resistance. It basically tested multiple times. The best part is there was a Moribazu. So after the Moribazu, you saw some kind of upbuild taking place, almost trying to go on the upside. But what we saw over here after this, a selling came by, and today it basically entered in the red candle. So this is a clear indication that upside might now be capped. From the higher side, DXY is not very strong, plus USDINR can go down. So what I see is basically a spike down on USDINR, almost 50 to 60 paisa on the downside. So if you get a chance, you can basically look at a put option. In the money put option can also be a successful strategy for this expiry, because there are almost 13 days left now, and it can be a very good risk reward from risk reward point of view. So trying to buy a put for USDINR, because this is what I see from DXY USDINR. So let's just open the option chain just to get a glimpse as to what kind of strategy can be placed on options of currency. Right, so we just go down to equity derivatives, sorry, currency derivatives and USDINR. So on the USDINR front, it's already 20 paisa down today, but it might recover a bit. But the point here is 68.5 is what the currency is almost trading at, 68.5. And you look at the right hand side, this is the put option. Obviously 68.5 is trading at around 24 paisa or so. Right. So if I buy 68.5, it will cost me 24 paisa, or if I buy 68.75, right, so it's basically charging me 40 paisa. Right. So the point here is this 40 paisa, if the currency goes down by 70-80 paisa, straight away you will get 70-80 paisa over here. So rather than that, you can basically buy at the money 68.5. So we can start tracking 68.5 at around 25 paisa, which should go down to 75 paisa if the currency goes down by 75 paisa or so, right? So this will almost go towards 75 paisa plus is the target for this put option of 68.5. So the risk reward is 1:3 to 1:5 range. You can basically look into it, or otherwise you can also create a spread by buying 68.5 and selling maybe 68 or 67. Important is 68, so that the cost will also get reduced. So these are the two formats you can track: either the bear spread 68.5 and 68, or just buying a put option, which is a little costly right now, but given the risk reward, it's worth taking a chance. So this is where the currency impact seems to be. Now, since dollar is weak, so we also go out and see the oil factor. Now, already something happened in oil. On the monthly basis, if you see, oil was going up smoothly on the higher side. Now, what exactly happened over here? On the month-on-month basis, the top was made and it is coming down. Now, there is no huge downside for oil. Obviously, we need to understand whether this month ends up almost towards the lower side or not. Right. So, let's see whether it ends up in this range for this month. If not, then you can see the lower side. But if I go on the weekly, the things become pretty much clear. So, what exactly has happened after this Moribazu? It has gone up, right? There was a stride, came back down, took some support at this end. Now, this rise was very fast, right? So this rise was very fast. That is why you're seeing a swift downfall in the action. So the first point of observance is obviously oil can come towards 68, 66, from 68 to 66. So more downside is there on oil as well. The important point is to understand whether these lower levels can be breached or not, right? So there will be some sustenance at the lower level. So there won't be a huge downside because there are multiple supports which can come into place. So oil seems to be losing some amount of strength, but obviously it will remain range bound. So that is the takeaway of oil. And obviously oil undergoing 5% downside and stuff, it basically helps Nifty as well. Now let's go out and see what's happening on Nifty and Bank Nifty. So what we saw, let's start first from the weekly point of view. So Nifty on the weekly chart seems to be similar like S&P, but a little bit different. So what I see over here is where the gap was formed prior, right? Came down, came back up, and here multiple level were basically made around these 10,800 mark, right? So this is where it came back again, came back down, and then you saw a good upside rally which took in place. Now on the weekly side, what I see on Nifty is a downside which is coming into place. Now the first point of downside should be understood, because this is the point where it will find some support. So if you just see the low which was made on yesterday also was around 10,925, and the high which was made was also around 10,925. So almost the low is touching the high of the previous candle which was there in the weekly format. So this becomes one of the support point for a shorter time frame to understand. But if it reverses, the positive week becomes positive. And if week becomes positive, there is a good chance of it breaching all-time high, right? So all we want is this entire week turning out to be positive. So the most important point is now to see on the daily side, are we finding any kind of reversal or not? So what we see on the daily side, this was the peak that basically took place during the election, and then it came down. It never reached over here. It breached. It also tested over here once, came back, and today the same lows have been maintained. So what will happen? 2 days, same low getting maintained will give some good amount of support to Nifty. So this is the important point to watch out for. And if it undergoes a fall below this point, then there is a serious trouble of Nifty climbing 11,000 or so. So this is very important for us now. 10,930 are the levels to be watched out for. Now the important point is this is a kind of red Moribazu which has been formed, and now it is trying to go on the upside. So obviously it might take 2 days to reach the upper level of the Moribazu. So climbing 11,000 will not be that easy. And important is whether it can sustain the base of 10,930. So that is the most important point for us to consider. Even if I look on 3-hourly or 4-hourly chart, things are pretty much the same. What happened yesterday was something which was predefined. So if you see over here, what exactly happened was multiple times this low was tested, right? So once, twice, thrice, the gap up has happened, and multiple times it got tested. Once it breached, it filled the gap, came back up exactly to the same point of 11,000, right? So obviously after that, the fall was pretty much on the cards. But the, now the point is the lower end is now being maintained. So what I see on the 3-hourly chart, 10,930 becomes a good support point. Important is this level where multiple supports were taken, were breached. This is where the resistance will come. So 11,000, as I said, on the red Moribazu is now the critical point for Nifty. Once it crosses 11,000, there is no stopping, right? So the only point that we need to now focus is 11,000 on the upside and 10,930 on the lower side. Both the gates get open. But if we get good amount of support from currency, oil, and S&P, I see 11,000 getting breached and 11,200 on the cards, right? By next 5 to 10 days. So this is where you need to focus now for Nifty if we are trying to target the Nifty spreads. Going out, even on the hourly side, the structure remains the same. The good hour, 1 hour, if you see right in the morning, it was trying to struggle. So kind of struggle on the higher side of 11,000. As I said, 11,000 will be now most important point. Multiple supports were there. It got breached. So many sellers will come into place. So if you try to see, these were the support points, so exactly known as the buying point. These will now become the sellers for Nifty. So 11,000 will be a point where multiple selling will come into place. But once this is taken out, there is no stopping for Nifty, right? So this is very, very important takeaway that we get from last 2 days action of Nifty. Now, what we see on even on the 5 minutes or 15 minutes chart to understand the intraday trend. So yesterday, what we saw, as I was explaining, it went down, it came down, it tested the same high again, and again started going down. So there was a clear indication of downside. But now this is very, very important and exciting. For 15 minutes, continuous base was formed at these levels, right? So if continuous base were formed at these levels, this becomes my critical point of structure to keep in mind. Now going on the higher side, obviously see, just see if it reaches almost towards 11,000, you saw a good spike on the downside. So that clearly shows amount of selling taking place at the higher level. And many people will sell thinking that this level will be breached, 10,930. So keeping this as your stop loss or understanding this as an important base, you can basically go against the wind. If 11,000 goes out, you can scale it up and it will zoom like a rocket. So this is what one clear understanding should have, one person should have. When many at times the same base is being formed for a large amount of time. So what I see on the 15 minute candle for intraday purpose, it was a good upside that we got. And obviously this first time it cannot just breach 11,000. So we got a spike down, and let's see now, second time also it will be a spike down. So second time again it approaches this range, you will find selling coming into place. Now let us analyze how this rally has started. Obviously there will be some gainer and loser. The most important gainer and loser will be from the oil marketing companies, because the oil went down pretty much. So what I see over here straight away, HPCL, IOC, all are on the top cards. The most important is to see ICICI Bank. So who was the biggest loser yesterday, bringing entire Bank Nifty down and bringing some pressure from banking side on Nifty, was ICICI Bank. So today what I see is something important straight away, 2% up. This is where we should go and look out what exactly happened in ICICI Bank right in the morning. The second most important takeaway, if you see in the losing side, the best loser is HUL. So this, if you see on counts of good results, HUL is being punished. So this is what I keep saying. Before the result, the expectations were good. It basically gave inline results. It went up, and now what you see after the result, a straight downside. Now obviously there won't be a huge downside for HUL because it is a defensive play. So when many people will start buying HUL at the lower levels. Kotak, Bajaj Finance, these were all trading at 52 weeks high. Right now suddenly they feel some kind of pressure on the downside. So let's go and focus on HUL, what exactly happened. Let's focus on ICICI Bank, what exactly happened. And then go out and see Bank Nifty. So first let's open HUL. So when I see HUL, so let's first go on the daily side. So before the result, what exactly is happening over here? Every day, as I said, small candles, then going up, then pushing up. But what happened in the last 2 days? The candles were very, very, very weak. So what I see in this entire expiry, it has just zoomed up one way. Obviously, what happens, I'm not saying that it can go down or not, but agenda is pretty much clear. If you have a doji or a gunshot at the top, what has happened right in the morning, it opens gap up. And when you see it going down, obviously it has to climb below yesterday's low. Then your short can be triggered. So the confirmation is pretty much only after yesterday's close, yesterday low or yesterday's close. So if I see over here something which is very, very exciting, and this can basically become a good trading strategy. 2 days high was almost equal to yesterday's close. Right? So what's happening over here? 2 days high was exactly equal to yesterday's close, and the low was also in that area itself. So this basically gives you a very good benchmark called as 1751, right? So 1750 now becomes a very critical point. Now if you go out inside and see what exactly happened in the first 15 minutes, tried to spike up, selling came, and a complete wonderful candle comes down. But this candle basically gives you a lot of strength on the downside, which is 1750. So straight away 1750 below this, you are very much confirmed. Once it starts coming up, you can look for a sell on this counter. But the most important point to understand over here, as I am saying, there won't be a huge downside. So if it has gone down by 2% or so right from the top, if you see, it will not have a huge downside. There is a clear indication of buying interest coming into play. So if you see 1, 2, 3, 4 candles can be taken out, and the buying will start around the 1680 to 1700 levels. So there won't be a huge downside, but again, you can, if you have missed the selling opportunity, you can now look for buying opportunity of HUL on intraday basis, provided that it reaches the multiple level of support. If you see, is around 1675. So this was the previous high, multiple support took place around 1675. So the spike or today, it can bring him down towards these level of 1675. Once it comes here and finds some kind of reversal on the intraday format from tomorrow, gap down bullish can be used as one of the good trigger for HUL, right? So keep that in mind. Second, taking the biggest loser, ICICI, right? So yesterday ICICI basically broke the back of Nifty and Bank Nifty and everyone. Now let's see what's happening on the daily side. On the daily side, it was very, very difficult to stop ICICI because things were pretty much clear. What exactly happened? Multiple levels of lows were broken. So what has happened over here on ICICI, what I see is the levels where 267, 268 kind of levels were easily broken, and then it went almost all the way down. Something which is exciting now, how come it straight away opens with gap up, right? And it starts zooming higher. Obviously, the same case as Nifty, as I said, for 11,000, same case applies for ICICI. ICICI will face higher resistance at this zone of 267, because this is the point where multiple supports were taken prior. Even 267 or 266 is the kind of range where ICICI will face good amount of resistance. So keep that in mind. And now let's see, intraday, can we pick ICICI or no? So when I now go, let's say even on the hourly chart to understand something. So what has exactly happened on ICICI? ICICI opened straight away, gap down yesterday, pulled itself down. But on the hourly side, what I see over here, it basically formed a congestion zone for the entire rest of the day. So 5 hours of congestion of ICICI not going down any further, but I could say a small range was basically formed. So can I say on the hourly candle, this was the higher range and this was the lower range. Something which is very exciting, if you see on the hourly time frame, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 candles almost in that hourly format going in this range. And today what happens, it straight away opens gap up above all the R candles high, right? So candles of hourly going in the narrow range, and next day if it opens gap up above the hourly range, it is again a good buying strategy. So these are the two learning points that we got from HUL and ICICI, picking up the reverse trade and exactly in a good fashion, right? So two learnings that we got. Important is to analyze and understand how these levels are made. So for 6 hours, if it is remaining in this range of 258 and 260, if it would have opened below 258, straight away gap down, then you would have found one more selling coming into place. But rather than down, what happened? It opened gap up above the hourly candles. Straight away, it pushes itself to the higher level. Now what you see over here, same as Nifty, it pushes itself to the higher level over here, almost to the zone where the gap down had happened. So I can safely say almost trying to bridge or fill the gap on the higher side, right? So it tries to fill the gap on the higher side, but obviously it will take some time to cross this gap. So I would basically see ICICI, if the ICICI crosses 267, there will be no stopping on Nifty. So Nifty can go past 11,000 if ICICI passes this 267 test. Right, so it is also trying to bridge the gap, and if it breaches the gap, it can provide support to Bank Nifty, and then obviously you have HDFC and all results coming on the way. This is where the good support can come from ICICI. Now let's go inside, and even if I look on the 15-minute chart, this is what I see: the gap down almost pulling on the downside, gap up, and the upside resumes to almost to the highest level. Right, it is now obviously it will take some setback. But the point is, if it doesn't go down much and tries to come back to the same time, it might take 2-3 turns to breach this 267. But if it breaches 267, you can find further round of rally in ICICI Bank. So this will in turn provide support to the Bank Nifty. Now there's one more stock where the results were out, Z, which was there. So let's first focus Z on the daily chart. Now Z was also one of the good contenders of the good results, but the problem was multiple brokerage houses, CLSA, basically gave a sell rating to Z, and that is where we found a huge downside which was happening on Z. Now something which is important to understand, after this huge downside, it is now trying to form some base around that base of Moribazu. So let us see whether it will resume on the higher side to go above 520 levels, and if yes, there will be a clear upside on Z straight away towards 534 and then towards the higher side of 545 or so. So let's keep an eye on Z as well. So right now there is no upside which has been seen, but obviously after 516 or 515, you can basically see a resume upside coming into place. But also understand, on the weekly time frame also, if you see, Z has never been seen this level. So what I see over here, continuous upside which came back down, again upside comes down, and this is the first time it tries to breach to the lowest level, was 490. So this becomes a huge support level for Z on the lower side. So if not this, in the next month also after this, we can look out for Z, because there will be a clear indication of bounce back from this level or 490 straight away towards 550 zone. So that will be a good trade, if not in this expiry, maybe in next expiry. So Z can also be kept in focus. Then you have Tech Mahindra, which has also seen some amount of good potential upside. So what I see on Tech Mahindra, on the weekly side, came back down, formed a base of 635, almost nearing the base. So this week also we saw almost touching 635. So 635 becomes a good benchmark for Tech Mahindra. It can be a buy candidate around these levels. of 640 or 645 for a higher target of 700 to 720. Now the point here is Tech Mahindra results are very, very late after the expiry. So rather than rushing into it right now, you can basically look out or wait for some time for the higher side. So if I look on the daily side, what I see over here, it is basically after the fall, it's been going. This was the first bounce, right? So this is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. So this is a good sign of Tech Mahindra. What we see on the higher side, it has been stuck with the higher range, and the lower range is around this 435 level, 665 level on the higher side. Keeping this in mind, it will keep going sideways. But the important point to understand is if towards the expiry, if we get something like this on lower highs are been made or higher lows have been made, right? So if it starts making candles around these sides, 665 will be taken out and it will zoom towards 720 in no time. So keep that on the radar, but the higher side gets capped for now for Tech Mahindra around this 665 levels. Now let's take even the other guy called as India Bull Finance. So India Bull also has the results, dates are out, it is a little late. So we can keep an eye on India Bull as well. So India Bull, what has happened, the same thing as what we are seeing on Tech Mahindra. On the higher side, it made a base around this 117 mark, long back, took the bottom up, then again came down to the same base of 715 or so. Then what happened over here, after that it comes back down. So what happened yesterday was gap down bullish. This clearly shows the base will never come to these levels again. So if IBUL has to sustain these levels, these are the levels where multiple support has been taken prior as well before the huge rally came into place. So what I see over here is a very good sign which we got for the first time in the second bounce. So it was like Tech Mahindra, first was just a spike, second was a good bounce, and this is where it is again trying to make an upside on IBUL. Now the point here is pretty much clear. Again, the results have good amount of time. So the results are not about a week away. So do not rush into the trade, but this will be an amazing trade because of gap down bullish opening. What has happened today also, it is gap down bullish. So these candles can basically give us more confidence on these kind of scripts when the results are nearing. You can see a good upside coming into play. Again, the same, I would suggest IBUL going in the narrow range. On the higher side, it can reach towards 1240 or maybe higher than that. But the most important point which I keep looking now for IBUL also is to basically see the higher lows getting into place, right? So this is what towards the expiry should happen. The lows should be on the higher side so that a breakout is equally possible. So keep an eye on Tech Mahindra and IBUL. ICICI about 267 will be very, very crucial. Coming down to Bank Nifty. Now when I see Bank Nifty on the weekly side, so what happened yesterday was something frightening on Bank Nifty. So what exactly happened over here, as I had already discussed, this triangle breakout on the weekly format. After that breakout, it comes back down, almost makes a low to the same level, right? So this was the base of the upside which happened on the weekly candle, and the same low was made in this start of the week. Now, there's something which is frightening because here, if you see, the Bank Nifty is still in red. So it has to basically turn itself up. So that is the first point for Nifty gaining some kind of strength. Now, what happened over here? This is what I was trying to say. Went up for the week, came down, almost making the same low, which was the start of the week. So something which is very, very clear. Also, the trend breakout took place that we already know. But the point is now, as what we were discussing for Nifty, the same applies for Bank Nifty. Now 26,600 becomes a very good support range. 600 to 26,650 is the kind of support range for Bank Nifty as well. Now we need to basically see whether it starts going up, or the most important point for Bank Nifty will be around this 27,000 mark. 26,900 to be more precise. The basically the top and the low of the red candle, which was formed yesterday. So this becomes a make or break situation, because once it crosses 26,900, then obviously the green, the week becomes green. And once the week becomes green, it can have a substantial upside coming our way. So this is very important point to note now. Same is for Nifty, same is for Bank Nifty. The most important point for Bank Nifty, if you try to see multiple times same high has been made on the day candle, then 2 days same low has been made. So what has happened over here? This has become a very crucial point. So 26,900 is like make or break for Bank Nifty, and similarly on the downside 26,650. So these are the 2 points which I have also given for Nifty. Same applies for Bank Nifty. So mostly this is the above point which we will keep in focus. Once it crosses, there is no looking back, because then we go out and see there is no potential downside for Bank Nifty. Once it crosses substantially, the upside gets opened afterwards. So what has happened, if it comes back over here on the higher side, it has already tested it once, right? So this was the first time when it went down. Second time it went down. Now it is trying to go up again. So third time mostly it will have way more chance to breach on the higher side. So keep that in mind for Bank Nifty and for Nifty. Now we have two important levels because of the sell-off which we saw yesterday. And obviously the sell-off was brought by ICICI Bank. Just to get something in perspective, HDFC Bank, and we can also see the other stocks, are they getting kind of support or not, or are they giving away the gain? So what I see on HDFC Bank, it's almost above the high range, right? So the previous high has been broken substantially. Obviously, you'll find some selling at the higher levels. So HDFC Bank seems to be strong. Kotak Bank today seems to be weak, but let us see, the structure still remains robust. This was the gap down bullish candle which was formed, the base of the Muribazu, and this is where the narrow range gets built for Kotak Bank as well. So Kotak Bank is also strong. Yes Bank has been flying high, but if you see, the ride has been very fast. Now it is taking some pause, but still it is trying to zoom on the higher side. So multiple times it has tested these base. So now for Yes Bank, 373 becomes a good base, but then after this, a huge upside is still possible for Yes Bank. Axis Bank has been showing some strength, but gave away all the gains. What we saw over here was a good strength, and then all the gains were given away. Now the most important point for Axis Bank also can be a good trade, provided that it goes above 527. So even in the intraday basis, if Axis Bank crosses 527, which is the top of the Muribazu, it can zoom on the higher side straight away to 540. So this can be a very good trade to keep an eye on. So 527 getting out can basically reach towards 540 or so. And the base is getting intact. So that is a good point. From last 4 days, 520 has not been breached. And once 527 is taken out, you can see a clear upside of 540. So that's Axis Bank. ICICI we have already seen. We can also look at IndusInd Bank, so that all private banks are taken care of. Now what I see on IndusInd Bank after the result, we have basically seen a downside on IndusInd Bank. Now try to understand, the results are good. Obviously you'll find some selling coming into place, but the most important point over here, if I see IndusInd Bank, let's say even on the weekly chart, it is in the support zone. So nothing to worry on IndusInd Bank. Obviously there will be some downside, but the point is pretty much clear. It is now in that support zone where multiple times the support has been taken place. So IndusInd Bank can come down to 1883, which is like 1% away from the current price, but there it can then find some kind of bounce back coming into place. So kind of all the banks are in good shape. It's only ICICI Bank who spoiled the party yesterday. Actually, it was also needed, because the markets cannot just zoom high one way. So let's see whether those things can sustain and it can go on the higher side. Keeping an eye on the oil marketing companies, because if we are seeing oil under some kind of pressure, just let us see what's happening on HPCL, BP and IOC. So what I see on HPCL, which is something interesting, obviously the gap up was there because of the 5% fall which has happened. But this is again very, very interesting, because if you see over here, after a good gap up opening, if it tries to sustain, which it will do for today, there is a huge upward potential on HPCL. So what I see after this 281, there is no one who can basically stop HPCL to reach to the higher levels of 295 or so. So these kind of trades towards the expiry can be an amazing trades to take, where the cost of the option goes down. And if things go in your favor, do not cut it fast, because if 281 gets taken out, in one day itself, it can reach to 295, right? So those kind of trades are very rare to get but I think there is a quite possibility in this expiry to look out for these kind of abrupt opportunity and can give you a good upside on the option spreads. So keep an eye on HPCL, since HPCL is the strong foothold compared to BP and IOC. So I would basically go for HPCL. Let's see what's happening on BPCL. The same thing has been happening on BPCL. It's been down, underwent such kind of congestion, then started going upward. The setup seems to be same for BPCL. The upside is very, very clear. What I see over here, there is no Muribazu left to be taken out. So HPCL might have a small hurdle, but what I see on BPCL, it's a clean pathway towards 410 or so, right? So these are huge potentials that can happen. Obviously, today it is open gap up. Everyone would be interested in the OMC. It might come down, but I would say towards the expiry, since everyone were bearish on OMC, I can see a huge upside happening in this expiry. Right, so keep that, keep OMCs on your radar, specifically BP and HPCL, and you can basically clog out a good intraday trade or basically a good spread trade towards the expiry. So let this week go by, let the settlement of oil takes place. Everyone would have digested the oil has gone down by 5% or so. Let them come down, and if you pick up a reversal, it will next time go towards 410 or a higher upward target can be achieved. So keep an eye on these OMCs, which are not the favorites of the market. Please understand, they were on the short side and people were only interested to short, right? So they have shown good amount of resilience. What we see here also on BPCL, above the large amount of resistance base of 376, have also been touched twice, now making higher lows, can basically form a good upside at the end of the expiry. So end of the expiry, it can be a good stroke to understand. Try to focus on Nifty 50. Don't go for Ashok Leyland or Adani Enterprise and all these stocks. It does not make sense. You'll not end up making money, right? So focus on these BP, HPCL, India Bull, Tech Mahindra, all these stocks which are good enough, which can give you a large amount of upside. So keep focus on those. And we have already discussed something about USDINR, which I strongly believe can have a downside potential of 50-70 pips on the downside, which can also give you a good risk reward in options. So what I see after a doji formation at the top, it has not been able to take out, and continuous selling has been seen by RBI on the higher side. Now this is the red Muribazu, two candles forming above the Muribazu. So that is a good positive sign, but what I see after that, what's happening, it is now trying to breach the base of Muribazu. There are two big things that will happen. After breaching the base of Muribazu, and these are the multiple resistance which were there. After breaching this, there will be no stopping for USDINR. It can go down one way in one session or two session itself. It can basically give you 50 paisa on the downside. So that is why we are targeting at the money or in the money option 68.5 for our study, so that we can at least get 70 paisa on the downside when it happens. Right, since you are trying to be since we are approaching towards the expiry, hence we are going towards at the money kind of options, or in the money can be are of the focus for USDINR. Right. Thank you very much for joining in. We will connect again tomorrow.